Hey guys, I'm here in Samuel Taylor Redwood Forest in California, and I just found a baby blue jay. Isn't it cute? And it balances on my finger. Whoa, he really hangs on. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes.
So here's the finished bird. It can fit like this, or it can go on your thumb. It goes upside down. And you can also put tulips inside, and you have a little birdie bouquet. And I have a separate tutorial for the tulips.
All right, so for this baby blue jay, I'm going to use a 6-inch square commie. Let's begin colored side up and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now rotate and fold this front flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge, but don't make the whole fold. Just align the edges, and we're just going to make a pinch mark right there. And unfold, and now fold this corner to this point. Crease sharply and rotate, and now fold this corner to this point. And now rotate and fold this flap up so that the fold aligns with this edge. And unfold, bring this flap on top, and now fold this flap up, aligning the fold with this edge. And now fold this flap. And now fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And repeat on this side. Okay, now completely unfold. And turn over, so white side is up. And now we're going to make a rabbit ear. So let's fold on this crease, and on this crease, and pinch the corner. And we don't need to flatten it. Just let it stick up like that, and repeat on this side. Okay, now fold in half like this. And fix up your folds if they're off like mine are. Okay, now fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And repeat on this side. And unfold those two flaps. And now fold this flap over and repeat. And now fold this edge to this edge. So we're just reversing the crease. And repeat. And unfold. Now open this pocket, and we're going to spread squash. This is a little bit tricky, so watch carefully. What we do is it's like this, and you just have to push down on this point, and you want to try to flatten it like this. So it's a diamond. So it's like that, and now we're going to do the same thing on this side. It helps to kind of push in there.
Okay, now turn over and fold this flap up like this, right on these two points. And fold this wing, yes, that's one of the bird's wings, over like this, and this flap over like that. And now let's fold this point to this point, but we just need to make the fold on the right side. So fold from about here over. And now unfold and fold this edge to the crease. And repeat on this side. Now unfold those two flaps and turn over. And now fold this flap over on these two points. And now open this pocket we're folding on this crease and flatten it so that these two edges align. So it's like this. I'm going to do this again so that you see what's going on. So it's like this, and we're folding on this flap and we're folding on this crease and flatten like that. Okay, and repeat. Okay, now let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with that edge. Like that. And now fold the flap back so that it touches this point and it's a 45-45-90 triangle. So that edge and this edge have equal length. About like that. And now open this pocket and squash it. So there's one eye. And now let's repeat on this side. I wasn't quite as exact. And open the pocket and squash it. So there are the eyes. Now we're going to make the beak. So what you want to do is open this pocket and we're going to fold on this line right there. So just wrap it over the edge like that and do the same thing on this side. So it goes up like that. So that's what it looks like. And now fold this corner to this point. And you really just need to fold on this side like that. And unfold, and now fold this corner to this point. And fold on the right side. And unfold, and now make both of those folds at the same time. And there is the beak. Okay, now it's time to inflate the model. So put your finger inside the top of the head and put it all the way to the bottom. Now just push on the bottom. And you want to make a curved fold. Well, you want to first pinch so that you see this fold right here aligns with this fold. And same over here. Like that. And now just push your finger in, and you want to mold the bird's legs around your finger. So it might help to just turn the little edges in. That'll kind of make it grab like that. Okay, so that's the legs. Now for the wings, reach into this point and just shape it to taste. So just pinch there. So it's like that, and same on the other side. Just reach in and pinch so it gives it a little wing. And bring the eye back into view like that. And you can shape the beak however you like. It's a little 3D. And these wings can either cross or come together like that. So there's the birdie. Isn't that cute? And it can also be a finger puppet. You can stick your finger in between like that. And it can go like a finger puppet. And it can also be a finger puppet like this. Or it can be a unicorn fish. Blub, 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 blub. So there you have it. All right, so even like this, the birdie will delicately balance on a flat surface. But if you put two coins in so that they end up inside like this, that, then the bird will balance like that and it will peck. And in this position, you can put the tulips in and you have a birdie bouquet and it can still peck. Or it can sit on its head. It can do a headstand, yeah. All right, hope you guys like this model and ooh, wow, it's a breakdancing baby blue jay. Wee-hee! All right, see you guys later.
Look, I just found a baby bird. Check it out. And come on up, come on up. Oh, oops. That's an outtake.
And it can even stand on its own and has an open top, which you can stick tulips in or not.